And now I present to you James B. Madonna and the Reverend Dr. William J. Eisenman.
Okay. I think everything is set properly there. All right. Welcome, everyone, to Progressive Discussions. Want to start Progressive Discussions? Get it out of the way. By saying everything we discuss here politically is part of our series Capitalism in a Conch Shell, Crapitalism in a Conch Shell. What's that, King Neptune? We're having a heat wave, a tropical heat wave here in the, the Northeast or New York metropolitan area, dangerously hazy, hot, and humid, with the humidity bringing the temperature today about 100 degrees Fahrenheit, right?
Index.
The heat index with the humidity.
105
degrees Fahrenheit, which is dangerous. And all outdoor activities, as far as I know, yes, they have been canceled. Even though you're nice and cool down in the deepest depths of the briny sea. But anyway, you're going to let me... Why be redundant if I'm going to talk about it anyway? You're right. Absolutely right, King Neptune. All right, I'll see. I'll talk to you. Bye-bye. I'm going to start with a little Chiseler's Hall of Shame, if you don't mind. a gentleman, I call named Jack. I'll just call him Gentleman Jack from Northern New Jersey. He calls me, contacts me by email first, and he says, you know, I needed my medical records from Bergen Regional Medical Center in Paramus, New Jersey. He says, a couple years ago, it cost them $40. $40. Now they want over $100 for his medical records. I says, are you kidding me? I always thought that the United States healthcare system was nothing but a blood-sucking racket, but I didn't know it was that bad. Just for your medical records, it went from $40 to over $100?
Should be free.
It should be free, especially if you need them. It sounds like very underhanded, unethical tactics
like
here.
Bank fees.
Like a bank fee, instead of like if you use your debit card, if you swipe it, it's supposed to come up insufficient funds for the transaction. Cannot complete transaction. Oh no, it doesn't do that. The bank pays it, but then they slap you with the $40 overdraft fee, like Bank of America. Yeah, right. So shame on you, Bergen Regional Medical Center, but I would honestly say that there are many more hospitals that are doing this highway robbery, extortion, whatever the hell you want to call it, blood-sucking tactics. How the hell could your records go from $40 to over $100? Totally insane. You know, it's Dr. Bill, it seems to me I'm sorry you're going through this there, Gentleman Jack, but I'm sure everybody is being exploited this way.
Mm.
It seems like every single aspect of the private sector within the capitalist system, whether it be retail, corporate, service-oriented, food service, warehouse work, healthcare, it all sucks. It's all dishonest. It's all despicable. There's nothing positive about any of it.
And it all treats the little guy as a cornucopia of funds.
Not yet. If you work for the private sector, they want you as slave labor.
Mm-hmm.
If you are a consumer, forget about them caring about the customer.
Uh-huh.
Good customer service. That's passé. Mm-hmm. No, if you're a consumer, they want the right to rip you off and lie to you in advertisement. If you work for them, they want you as their slave.
Okay.
So, I know you told me many times, I don't know if this was from a famous book or not, but you said since 1776, only 10% of the American population experience upward mobility.
It's approximation.
It's an approximation, but it's still...
Could be less than that.
A small amount of the population.
That's correct.
Just like the unemployment rate is actually higher than what they claim it is.
It's like a gentleman told me the other day, how capitalism is the way for everybody to get rich.
The American dream.
The American dream, whatever.
Oh,
capitalism.
So there's lots of opportunity out there, even today, right? According to this person.
Yes, absolutely.
You know, I'm glad you brought this person up because I've been doing some hard thinking about the...
Is your head hurt?
Oh, it hurts. The typical American middle-class tea publican. Ooh. The teabagger. Now, these people, more or less, and I know a couple of them personally, you know, some are lower middle class, like the first famous teabagger, believe it or not, was Archie Bunker. He was a lower middle class homeowner in Queens, New York, but he was right wing.
Mm-hmm.
And everything was, America, I'm number one, America, you pinko meathead, you commie pinko meathead. You know, so, and of course, he was bigoted, which goes with the personality way of thinking. Now, these people are struggling with many living paycheck to paycheck.
Mm-hmm.
Paying the bills, trying to raise their family, paying their mortgage, property taxes, income tax, so on and so forth. In this case, the burden of income tax is on the middle class. Now, these people, when they spout their right-wing ideology, and they... choose to support politicians that do not have their best interests, it is just like them shooting themselves in the foot.
Ow.
Because they, like way back when MSNBC was actually a much more, well, it originally was a progressive station, right?
Liberal.
Right.
Liberal.
When they had Ed Schultz and Keith Olbermann.
Well, even before that.
And even before that, okay.
But the word liberal, of course.
But.
The Republicans have demonized.
But the middle class that became teabaggers, tea publicans, they chose not to get their information from an MSNBC, but they chose Fox News.
Uh-huh.
Now, whether... Most of them are men, and they chose Fox News because of the hot chicks that they hire with the big breasts and the full lips, you know, like Tantaros and you know, women that were very easy on the eyes, like Megyn Kelly and the whole lot of them. I don't know what the reason is, but for some reason, they chose to get their news from people that blame everything on the poor.
From a channel that is like 87% wrong all the time.
Right, almost like a satire network. Almost like a political satire network. You know, like
yeah, they probably use a sarcasm like Trump did about Barack Obama and Hillary Clinton are the founders of ISIS. The founders.
What about G.W. Bush and Dick Cheney?
Oh, that's gone by the wayside.
Yeah, the media is up in arms. I read the article up in arms about the kid Malia trying marijuana.
Ah.
But nothing is said about all the civilians that are being killed by U.S. bombings in Syria. That was the banner, you know. But getting back to the Teapublican, whatever reason they have, they choose to listen not to the progressive information that tells them the truth about the conservative propaganda, but they choose to listen to the conservative propaganda. Uh-huh. And that propaganda blames everything on the poor that are living on social services, which make up 1-2% of the total budget. They never take into account the military budget. For instance, $6 trillion that's not accounted for.
It's more than that, believe me.
In the Pentagon.
Mm-hmm.
Now, $6 trillion. That is supposedly missing could have done a hell of a lot for the poor in America, and the veterans and the homeless and
there would be no poor in America.
It would eradicate it
totally.
So
but don't forget also, with George W. Bush's tax cuts, we lost $1.8 trillion in revenue.
Right.
Just for that.
Well,
it wasn't made up by, the middle class, of course, are paying more, but it wasn't made up. And then, of course, Medicare Part D and the war in Iraq and the war in Afghanistan were off budget.
Yeah.
Continuing resolutions.
Well,
they weren't paid for.
Yeah. Maybe these teabaggers rather blame the poor than the top 1%, because they still believe in trickle down economics, and you know you gotta.
They believe they will be in the 1%.
You can't.
One day,
you can't hurt the companies, the corporations, because they believe that bullshit about creating jobs in the United States. In the United States.
Yeah.
So I think that other article I read about Donald Trump supporters tend to have a much lower IQ.
You mean the Trumpanzees?
Yeah, the ones, you know, the photo with the Confederate flag behind them and the guy, they're all shirtless. They're fat, though. They got the beer belly and the bitch tits drooping, you know, and, you know, the... Democrats are going to come and taking our guns away from us. Yeah.
Well, Hillary's going to do away with the Second Amendment. How the hell can a president do that? But hey, that's their belief.
Well, anyway, maybe it's lack of IQ. It has to be something that goes on between their two ears, because
maybe it's something in the water.
People like myself, Dr. Bill here, Reverend Dr. William J. Eisenman, the people that helped me run the Facebook group and the Facebook page. You know, there are people out there. Yeah, your Ed Schultz. What's his name again? Ed Schultz.
Ed Schultz.
Your Ed Schultz and your Jill Steins and your Gary Knowles and your Ralph Naders and so on and so forth, Jesse Ventura. We obviously know the truth, and
the truth shall set you free.
You know, we're smart enough to know that you're voting for, unless you're a greedy, stingy, very mega rich person. voting for a Republican is very deleterious to your well-being. And voting for anyone that is supported by the corrupt, rigged DNC is also deleterious to your well-being.
Yeah, you see that Trumpy now was forced to take on the Republican tax plan.
Well, the Republicans are not crazy about Trump. See, this is why...
No, only some Republicans.
Right, this is what I don't... Like, if Julian Assange, or Assange, of WikiLeaks, he says he's going to reveal everything by this October of 2016. Who's he going to give it to? You can't give it to the FBI because those are Obama's boys. You can't give it to Loretta Lynch because that's Obama's woman. I mean, you know, his part of his administration. You can't give it to the Democrats because they are corporatists and corrupt. You can't give it to the Republican Congress because they don't want Trump, and they certainly don't want Jill Stein or Gary Johnson. So who's left? Hillary Clinton. Mm-hmm. So it's like, who do you give all that information to?
We used to be able to give it to a good reporter. But, how many of them are today?
The U.S. media.
Yeah.
That's a joke.
Like, back in Watergate with, what were those two reporters' names? It's off my head right now.
You know what? The media used to be... fairly unbiased.
Fairly
back
honest,
then.
Yeah. That's what it's supposed to be. It's supposed to be the fourth estate. It's supposed to keep the government's feet to the fire.
No, nobody's held accountable anymore. No. What we have is total chaos, not only in the world, but of course in the United States. It's total chaotic state, tohu, a modern tohu and bohu.
Hey.
Right?
Waste and desolation, yeah.
That's right.
Yeah. Well, that keeps the populace from demanding stuff. See, well, we gotta spend on we gotta take care of ISIS. We gotta do this. We need money. Trillions, 9 billion. By the way, speaking of the money, when I said about Bush, his problems. Hardly anybody from the other side, Republicans in the Senate, will tell you. When George Bush left office, he left Barack Obama with a deficit of $1.4 trillion. Barack Obama has brought it down to something like 600 and some billion.
Well, you know, even though Barack Obama's a corporatist, he did do some amazing things.
That's correct.
In the two terms that he was in. I mean, you got to give the guy credit.
Here and there, yeah.
Here and there, you know. I mean, we could have had a totally reformed healthcare system.
Universal healthcare, yeah.
Within the first 2 years of his administration, since the Democrats were in control of everything lock, stock, and barrel.
Yeah.
That didn't happen. It could have happened, but it didn't happen.
It didn't happen.
Just like, you know, taxpayers' money does not have to be pissed away with the Pentagon and the military spending.
Well, under crony capitalism, it has to be.
You know.
That's what they do.
Well, the thing is that Europeans have the intestinal fortitude and the courage and the spine and the balls. To get out there with torches and pitchforks, but Americans, they just don't have what it takes.
Yeah.
They're not. They're very pacifist. They're very. They want somebody else to do it for them. You know.
The fact of the matter is, they may not. They don't even know what they want done, because you see that in the the campaign of Bernie Sanders.
All right.
Somebody bitching about change, but when we got the opportunity to really get change, what happened? They chickened out.
No, well, you're still assuming that the voting count was on the up and up and
that's,
honest.
Well, that's part of the problem. I'm assuming that people who need change, maybe want change, did not vote for change.
They voted
for the status quo.
They were either afraid of real change.
Right.
Let's just use California primary as a perfect example. I mean, the millions of ballots that were just tossed.
There you go. That's what I'm saying. Other than the cheating that went on, I'm saying there is something in the vast majority of people, what is called the adaptive supporters, that just will not rock the boat.
You know, I'm glad you brought that up, because the bottom line is that those are the imbeciles that have arranged it so no one is held accountable for anything.
That's exactly.
No one's feet are being held to the fire because of them. Because
exactly.
If the Democratic primaries were totally rigged across the board, Bernie Sanders would not have won the, what the hell was it, 18, 19 states?
Yeah, 19 or 20.
Something like that. Bernie wouldn't have won any state.
Right.
Right? But apparently, you know what's funny? Even in some of the states where he won, they gave more delegates to Hillary.
Yeah, it was one state where he won. And
she
got seven delegates, and he got one or two. Well, that's the stupid system.
That's bizarro world. First of all, they're absolutely right about wanting to eliminate superdelegates. Okay, and they should also eliminate this fucking electoral college bullshit and just have the popular vote.
They've been yapping about that for years. It never gets done.
The popular vote across the board. No tricks up their sleeve. No gerrymandering. No this, that, and the other thing. Just old-fashioned popular vote across the board.
With a paper ballot that can be checked.
Yeah, but not...
No goddamn computer.
Not dumped from a dump truck on the side of the road. The paper ballots.
That are checked. That means once it's voted, it has to be counted.
Now,
and accounted for.
Hacking experts have showed on some videos how an electronic voting booth can be compromised.
Then the counters. The vote counters can be compromised. Yes.
Okay, that's it. That's it. I don't have any more Chiseler's Hall of Shame.
Well, that's a shame. What about the whatchamacallit? What about McDonald's?
Well, McDonald's that doesn't get their plumbing and central air fixed is franchise owned. But McDonald's is just a toxic, it's a food version of Monsanto. You know what I mean? I saw an article where the food industry or fast food industry got caught with all this mystery meat being pressed together into mystery boneless chicken wings. And you know what's in mystery meat. Hey, it's the same crap that's in supermarket hot dogs. Could be anything. You know, so, yeah, I mean, you just have to...
You just have to know that they're going to cheat you no matter what.
Look, you have to know what you're putting in your body. You have to, if you don't like to cook, learn how to cook, but healthy.
Yeah, but if nobody's going to label anything, how the hell are you going to know anything?
Yeah.
You ain't going to know what you put in your body.
And eat rice and beans for the rest of your life. You're right about
that. Well, they might GMO them.
Or they might,
then what do you
or they might call it something nice, and it could be genetically modified. They could lie.
Yeah.
Who's to stop any company in the United States from just flat out lying to you?
None. Nobody.
You know, I was talking to Matt Dishman. You know, he's from a southern state. I think he's from Tennessee. I could be wrong. He's from a southern state, and he's been having this very severe gastrointestinal problem that that requires immediate medical attention. He claims he hasn't pissed or defecated in a week. Because that's all I do. I don't know how. I said, you better go to the ER pronto.
Yeah.
He says, well, I don't have health insurance. I don't have this. I don't have that. I says, well, go to a hospital that has charity care. You know, it's like Medicaid. Oh, no, I don't want nothing with the word charity on it. I'd rather have them put it on my tab. I says, are you out of your mind? You want to have a health care put on your personal tab? See, and that goes back to that the mentality from that region of the country, like Mr. Nathan, Nathan Bates, was saying, you know, the Protestant mentality.
Is he from Psycho?
Huh?
Nathan Bates, ain't he from Psycho?
Yeah. No, to worry about your pride and not want to take a handout. Meanwhile, you need to take a handout, but they don't want to take it.
What about fiber for this guy?
Well,
you're a fiber.
I told him about aloe vera juice. I told him about ginger. I says, yeah,
I mean, a necessary fiber every day. You know that.
But the guy says he hasn't been peeing.
Metamucil or regular. He ain't eating vegetables. Obviously.
I mean, look, if somebody's plugged up, constipated, I can understand there are things you can take.
But you can die. That's how Dr. Feldman died.
You mean?
Darren, I'll say.
Dr. Marty Feldman did not follow.
He ate out too much.
He didn't listen to Gary Noe.
He didn't listen to himself, because obviously he must have known better.
That's why Gary Noe scolded him than once on the radio show. So he was like Stuart Berger. He didn't practice what he preached. You know, Stuart Berger died from a cocaine overdose, I believe.
Ooh.
He writes books about nutrition, telling you what not to eat. He was a Pritikin guy. He demonized all fats and all dietary cholesterol. So, you know, and he had a drug. Carlton Fredericks was a chain smoker.
And a coffee drinker. Heavy.
And, you know, so we're talking about people that obviously did not practice what they preached.
Yeah.
And that's that. So, all right. I know we were long-winded, but it was kind of important. Well, not that bad. We have about 30 minutes before lunch. So, let us sink our teeth into these readings.
It's the media's fault. That's out of context. Never said it in the first place. Hmm? Donald Trump's claim Friday that he was merely being sarcastic in accusing President Obama of establishing a terrorist group, was his latest attempt to blame others for the uproar over what he says.
Establish it. That's a big statement.
It's an instinct that Trump's opponents say a president cannot possess. Some Republicans seem to have the same concern. This time, it followed 2 days of critical headlines and Democratic outrage over Trump's claim that Obama was the founder of the Islamic State group ISIS.
Well, Donald Trump's statements and his reactions have even Republicans scared. They're worried.
Yeah, some of them, maybe 70 of them, who signed a letter against him. As Trump repeated the claim more than a dozen times, interviewers sought to ensure Trump wasn't being misconstrued. Surely, they offered, he meant Obama's policies had enabled the extremist group's rise. No! I meant He's the founder of ISIS.
What? Is he out of his mind?
I do, Trump said, using one acronym for the group.
Well, because why? Because his last name is Obama, you know, and that whole Bertha thing, and I don't know.
Then, an about face on Friday. They don't get sarcasm, he tweeted.
Not when you're running for president.
Or was he being sarcastic about the sarcasm? Hours later, he told a rally in Pennsylvania he was obviously being sarcastic. But not that sarcastic, to be honest with you. That it took Trump 2 days to walk back this widely debunked remark and then walk back the walk back was worrying for Republicans who see such missteps as playing to Democrats Hillary Clinton.
The levity bells. Trump is Trump, man. He's a showman.
Of equal. Speaking of Trump, Trump. I saw a video yesterday.
He's still doing this on TV. Hillary's showing his.
Where he was walking into his Trump Towers.
Yeah.
And there were some people, Trump supporters, standing around.
Yeah.
And one girl with a sign, Trump sign, and she wanted him to sign it. As he's walking in the door,
sign a sign.
It's like a mafia don is coming in the door with all these soldiers around him. I swear to God, it looks just like a don.
They're wearing dark outfits.
Every one of them, dark black long coats.
I thought he admits he packs heat, but he has bodyguards.
Oh, he has Secret Service also.
I hear...
He has his own and Secret Service.
I hear... I hear Hillary's had, for the last 30 years, armed guards. Armed guards.
Yeah, because even after you're retired, you still get some support.
And let me guess, the taxpayers have to pay for all that...
Bingo!
For all that security.
That's right.
For not only the president, but the president's family. Former president's family.
Yep.
Oh, gee. But they have no money for food stamps.
No, because the poor have to be forced to work.
What if the poor say, fuck you? How do you like that, man?
Well, then I guess corporations wouldn't be able to put out their product.
Hey, you know what? Could you imagine if Americans had the intelligence enough
of the French
to know? No, not even that. To know the power of the boycott? I don't watch any mainstream media at all, so therefore I don't see their sponsors' advertisements. And I'm boycotting both. And then Bill Morrow says, "Where have you been hiding under the rock? Mm-hmm. You didn't hear the." I says, "Bill, I got so disgusted all year with the shenanigans of mainstream media. I don't watch it."
Of equal concern for some was the fact he again would not take responsibility for his words.
No.
Ryan Williams, a Republican strategist who advised Mitt Romney in 2012, said there's a common sense playbook for dealing with political slip-ups. Stop the bleeding, put it behind you by apologizing.
Mitt Romney had a big slip up when he was being recorded.
The 47%.
Yeah, and that, and what about the information about the DNC calling the Latin voter the Taco Bowl, the Taco Bowl group or whatever?
And remember Jesse Jackson, Jaime Town?
Well, that's true. That's true. New York.
Well, you don't say it.
New York, especially Manhattan. Man with hat on, as the Cowie said on F Troop. It was named after a man with hat on. Manhattan is Jaime Town. But if you're in the public eye, you're not supposed to say it.
Yeah. That's what normal candidates do. However, normal candidates don't careen from one self-inflicted wound to another. It was only 2 days earlier that Trump blamed the media for making much ado about nothing after he suggested during a rally that gun rights enthusiasts might find a way to stop Clinton if she's elected. Clinton, whose lead over Trump has widened in recent polls of the most competitive states, has seized on those and other eyebrow-raising comments to portray the reality TV star as lacking the temperament to run the nation. Trump has his own argument for why she's unfit to do so.
So if the media criticizes Donald Trump, they're no good. If they criticize Hillary Clinton, they're great, according to Trump, I guess.
Well, Trump is getting ready to, he's saying that if he loses in Pennsylvania, it's because it's rigged. Pennsylvania's assembly and etc. are all Republican.
Oh, really?
So how can you say that? The Republicans are in charge.
Oh, yeah.
In Pennsylvania.
Yes,
you see what they were trying to do with the IDs just a while ago to stop the blacks and Hispanics from voting in Pennsylvania.
No, they want to stop.
So how can you blame, you know?
They want to stop anyone for that traditionally votes Democrat.
Yeah. But how can you blame it as a rigged system if your people are in charge?
Doesn't make sense.
Exactly. Well, anything he says doesn't make sense.
It's bizarro world.
She has hammered him
for
avoiding accountability for his actions. To that end, Clinton's campaign on Friday intensified the pressure on Trump to release his tax returns while disclosing her 2015 tax return. The filing shows that the Clintons earned $10.6 million and paid a federal tax of 34.2%.
That's it? You mean it, as a combined effort, 10.6? Really?
Trump has refused to make his filings public, saying they are under audit by the Internal Revenue Service, and he will release them only once that review is complete.
In a nanosecond, you release them like this. Bloop.
All major U.S. presidential candidates in modern history have released their returns. Minutes after releasing her returns, Clinton tweeted that it's possible Trump paid no tax at all.
Well, if General Electric doesn't pay, then I'm sure Donald Trump doesn't pay. It's amazing just how miserably stingy and greedy the super rich are. I mean, it's like, what is it? How much does it take for them to be content?
They're never content. That's what the problem.
I mean, you know, I remember when they showed Donald Trump's penthouse condo, whatever.
Condo.
Well, it was like
penthouse.
No, it was the whole floor. He owned the whole floor.
Penthouse.
It was like if you took a mansion and you build it on top of a skyscraper. It was the whole floor. He had a gold toilet seat for his ass. A gold toilet seat.
Yep.
Wow. Incredible, huh?
Trump worked to profit on the fuss over his Islamic State group remark. In an email to supporters asking them to donate, Trump accused the liberal media of telling outrageous lies about me. It's no surprise that the media are Trump's go-to scapegoat.
Look how many Americans love the guy. Are just enthralled by him.
About 30%, that's it. 30% of his people. The teabaggers.
Oh, they just happen to show on the media, they just happen to keep on showing the teabaggers.
Yeah,
so it looks like everybody loves him.
Yeah.
Alrighty.
But he doesn't get more support than 35 or 40%. That's not enough to win.
I hear Jill Stein is, in reality, is doing much better than they claim she is.
No, she's only 2%. She's not going to be in the debates. Gary Johnson is moving up.
That's not what Jill Stein's page says. about being her being 2%.
She better get 15% because Gary Johnson is, what is he, 9 or something?
He's closing in.
He's closing in. She's only at 2%. So I have no idea, but.
Well, she's not really. She's not really. Well, she. I only saw one Jill Stein advertisement.
So did I. That's it, just one.
And then the Hillary advertisement shows Donald Trump going.
Oh, I don't know what he said. I can't remember.
You know what? He was mocking him, but watching Trump do that was very funny. I'm sorry.
Just 6% of Americans said they have a great deal of confidence in the media in a Media Insight Project poll earlier this year.
Confidence in the U.S. media?
Well, but Billy was in there, 6%. Thank you. Almost never does Trump admit error. Error.
I am never guilty of anything. You misinterpreted.
That's what he does.
I said.
You took me out of context.
Out of context. It's like these corporate people. You know, when you call an office and you get some chicky poo on the phone, office manager, she talks real fast like she's loaded with caffeine. I'm very sorry, sir, that you went through this trouble. I'm very sorry, sir. I must apologize. Listen, stop apologizing to me. Just take care of the issue.
One exception came this month when he acknowledged a video he said showed a plane carrying U.S. cash to Iran was actually a plane carrying U.S. hostages who were being released.
Okay. You know, there is heavy-duty evidence from by watching Ancient Aliens last night.
The
wee hours of the morning, that the moon is hollow, and there's alien. It's an alien base. It's an artificial satellite, because when the Apollo crew dropped the rocket back on the room, it resonated like ringing a gong. For over an hour, there was a bell, like a bell ringing, which means there is metal underneath the surface, and all the craters are the same depth. How can all asteroids and meteors that hit the moon create the same depth? I'm telling you. And then there's the dark side of the moon, because the moon, the way it rotates, we always see the same face. All over the world, we only see the same face of the moon. We don't see the other side. I'm telling you, they're out there. All right. Go ahead.
The Bible happens to say different. The craters in the moon and etc. and the chaos in the universe were caused by the fight amongst the angels.
Well, the cosmonauts.
Which, Mr. Satan trying to take over the throne of God.
You know, the cosmonauts, they couldn't tell the Russian government, because then the Russian government would remove them from the space program back then, Soviet Union, and they would be deemed insane. But they saw extremely blindingly bright winged beings out of the window. Out of the window in space.
What were they doing?
They were observing the craft. There was a whole group of them, and they were like about 80 feet tall.
Yeah.
I had no idea. I don't know what they were, but 80 feet is pretty tall. You know, I don't know. So I don't know if it. Hey, if an angel's 80 feet tall, what the hell is so special about a human? That God decided to create man. I mean,
there is nothing special about a human right now, because he has been made a little lower than the angels, but his potential is much greater, because he is potential is to become a son of God. So a spirit being like unto God.
So right now
himself.
Right now, the resume of the angel or a fallen angel is much more impressive than a human's resume. But well, the human right now, has a course. Future potential.
That's correct.
What you're saying.
That is correct.
Because an 80-foot tall, supernaturally very powerful being is pretty impressive to me. I hire him in a second. And not hire the human. Anyway.
Governor Christie's argument actually highlights his and others' hypocrisy when complaining about activist courts. When courts refuse to uphold statutory law, they are considered hypocrites, idiots, or worse. Imagine if Christie were on the other side of the betting issue, and the court had ruled differently. At that point, he would immediately bloviate about overreaching activist courts. At the end of the day, an activist court is merely a euphemism for a court that issues a decision against Christie's own interests.
Christie, 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 Krispy Kreme Christie, Crisco Christie. How much longer does that dirigible have as governor of New Jersey? This is his last...
This is either his last year or it's next year. I think.
Okay. Oh, boy. Well,
Donald Trump is smart. Very smart. His sharp intellect allowed him to attend the Ivy League's Wharton School of Business.
Sure it wasn't because of his father pulling some strings?
Could be.
Not a braggart. He opted for a modest bachelor's degree. Not the pompous MBA.
No.
Being a humble guy.
Well, yeah, but he could...
You recognize sarcasm here?
If he was...
This is sarcasm, Trump.
If he was qualified for an MBA, Trump is the type of guy that would want the MBA.
That's correct. Being a humble guy...
Humble.
He also stayed clear of snobbish cum laude graduation honors.
Cum louder? Sigma cum, C-U-M, louder?
Ah! Woo! Regrettably, about 4,000 backstabbing Wharton alumni and faculty sent a totally misguided open letter to Trump, distancing themselves from his supposedly offensive campaign rhetoric.
They're jealous
and
of him.
Demeanor.
They're all jealous of him.
They're elitists.
That's what he could have said. You're jealous of everything. Everything about me, including my beautiful hair, my orange locks.
Graduating from military high school prepared Trump well for the role of future commander-in-chief.
So if you graduate from military school, which I'm surprised that's where he went, that automatically makes you a great president, right?
Well, remember, Palin said that since she can see Russia from where she lives, yeah. that she is a foreign policy expert.
Yeah. Plus, she has good eyesight. She's a foreign policy expert because she could see the coast of...
Russia.
Siberia. Yeah. Interesting.
Tragically, 5 deferments during the Vietnam War precluded him from pursuing a glorious military career.
He could have been a 4-star general or an
admiral. He possibly could become another Patton. Not being able to serve also destroyed his chance to earn a Purple Heart.
I can picture Donald Trump with his father pulling some strings again, having a uniform like remember when Red Fox on Sanford and Son did a thing like Patton? Like when George C. Scott played Patton, but he had medals everywhere. He had medals. You couldn't even see the uniform. I could picture Trump with like thousands of medals all over his body.
A heartbreaker, since he was yearning immensely for this valorous distinction. Valorous.
What? Valorous distinction.
Valorous distinction. I was by that moth over there.
Oh. I thought he was chasing a girl named Dolores. I don't know.
Valorous distinction.
Was that a woman's name?
No. Oh. It's being Valor.
Okay.
Valor. Trump is rich. Very rich. Warren Buffett is presumably even richer.
Really?
Most likely through sheer luck. And the unfair advantage of having encountered only one minor bankruptcy in his vast pool of investments.
Interesting.
In a campaign rally for Hillary Clinton, Buffett had the audacity to challenge Trump on releasing his tax returns.
All right. Was Warren Buffett willing to do the same?
I'm sure he did.
Order
available.
With all these billionaires in the United States, that should be pretty good tax revenue for this country, right?
Well, not if their taxes are cut every now and then, so that we don't get the benefit from the revenue that would be there.
Yeah, like old Turtlehead. Turtlehead was in a recent article, was complaining about the poor on social services.
There you go.
Again. Again and again and again and again and again. It's just a distraction to take your eyes off of what they're doing.
Buffett claims that given his personal wealth, he is permanently undergoing tax audits. But this would not prevent him from disseminating details. When Trump tells us that he has valid reasons for not disclosing specifics, we've just got to believe him. Didn't the past few weeks provide enough convincing evidence that he, and only he, can revive our ruined nation?
Only he. Interesting. If he's gonna... Alright, so... Since all of Donald Trump's products are made overseas, with cheap labor, and a couple of friends of mine in the Philippines were telling me, no wonder so many American businessmen seem to be visiting the Philippines. They said that we got all these factories sprouting up in the Philippines. I go, well, those are the scumbag American CEOs outsourcing all of our jobs, exploiting you Philippine people, paying you cheap labor, just like they do in China and Bangladesh. Rat bastards.
Mm-hmm.
The greed of capitalism. I like that. Yep. Anyway. I think we're going to break for lunch.
Yes, we are.
Break for lunch. You will now be joined by our...
station break.
Our voiceover specialist, William Hamilton, Morrow III, with promo and the How to Defeat a Conservative Bible Verses. Simply hit the pause button, read and learn. If you imbecile Americans are capable of doing that.
The hardest thing to unlearn is something that you've learned, and it's an error.
Oh, like all those fairy tale history books in school that I had to read.
That's it.
About George Washington chopping down a cherry tree.
I never tell a lie.
I cannot tell a lie. Didn't mention anything about the slaves they had on the plant on
their
plantations.
Never do.
Or what they did to Native Americans.
Never do.
You know? Yeah. Of course. Yeah, so all the brainwashing starts young. And then they grow up to be teabaggers.
You know? As long as they're listening to Fox News, that helps.
You know?
A lot.
You're not free. You're not fighting. If you're in the Middle East and you're a military person, you're not fighting to protect our freedom. You're fighting to free oil from the ground for the top 1% of the filthy rich. All right.
This is William H. Morrow. The best way to join our organization is to get your free annual subscription to Newsletter Censored with your gift to support this work. The newsletter of hard-hitting truth and news fighting censorship and conservative propaganda since 1977. There is nothing out there like the Newsletter Censored in the mainstream media or the press. This newsletter is the very best way to join and be a part of our organization. We're living the end times, so you need Newsletter Censored. Go to www.newslettercensored.com. Hey, listen, for the real hard-hitting truth, you need Newsletter Censored. And now, back to the show. Bye-bye.
All right. Thank you very much, William H. Morrow III, for promo. Now we will give you the balance of this show during one of the dog days of summer 2016.
It seems that the last few grown-ups still left standing in the Republican Party have guided Donald Trump to keep him on message for his latest proposal tax rollout. But true to form, Trump continues the deficit busting, trickle-down tax giveaway to the wealthiest few, which is a tax policy that has provided a Gilded Age disparity of wealth since its inception in the 1980s.
Oh, he's one of the wealthiest few, isn't he?
Yes.
Well, he's part, I would say.
But as I said before, he has taken over the Republican plan. Okay? He had his own plan before. Now it's down to three. And everybody pays taxes. His first plan, there were certain people who paid zero taxes. But the Republicans want some money from the poor. Okay? So they have three tiers instead of five, like Trumpy wanted to start it out with his own plan. Now he's doing the old Republican plan. Okay? It is a policy that gives massive tax cuts to millionaires and billionaires on the premise that they will then trickle down the wealth.
They don't even trickle it down with the outsourcing of jobs. They don't trickle down, period. No matter where it is on the planet Earth, it's a lie, the trickle down.
Well, we're still obeying it, aren't we, some people?
They believe in the conservative propaganda. It's the same story year after year, decade after decade.
And a policy that continues to tax an investor's income lower than that of a teacher, secretary, or a fast food worker. Throwing a small tax cut to the middle class while giving massive tax cuts to the wealthiest few is a failed tax policy we should abandon, not expand upon.
Well, you know, greed is not only a form of idolatry, I think it's a form of hoarding, a mental illness. It's like hoarding. You're hoarding money, you never have enough of it. You know, I'm not saying I feel sorry for them. I think they're evil scum. But, you know, see, this guy gets all huffy when I call somebody a name. You know.
Recently, Donald Trump gave a speech on his plans to improve the United States economy.
Yeah.
And his plans, I was very impressed with. His tax plan is dedicated to large tax cuts across the board and much needed simplification of the tax code, which has many complications and loopholes that hurt the average American and small businesses. As I said, that one does not exist anymore.
No.
He rolled out the typical Republican plan the other day.
That's because of his own greed.
No, it's because he has to be in line with the established GOP.
You mean a man as independent as Donald Trump is?
If he wants their votes.
Has to be in line?
That's correct.
Really?
If he wants their votes.
Donald Trump, the man that will tell you to go screw yourself before anyone else.
Who is he telling that to?
Whoever.
Certainly not Reince Priebus.
Whoever he feels like it. He's Donald Trump.
But he's not telling them, the established Republicans, that right now. As I said,
he's kissing up
their plan.
He's kissing up to them.
Paul Ryan's plan,
their plan. Is it's total greed, yes, but it's also a war on the poor.
Yeah.
Because Paul Ryan and Mitch McConnell, but Paul Ryan's a scumbag. He continues to bash the poor. He continues to blame everything on the poor.
But the point is that these same policies are adopted by all the GOP runners, whomever they are.
Well, which means Donald Trump is full of shit. He doesn't care about anybody but his own ilk.
Well, he sees himself losing, and he does not wish to be a loser. So he's been forced into taking these policies.
Because some of the Republicans were backing Hillary Clinton.
Well, that's what they say. And 70 old-time established GOPers wrote a letter. Get rid of him. He's no good for America.
Yeah. You know what's no good for America? Not having term limits on your sorry asses.
Well, we do have term limits.
On everybody? Congress?
2 years for the House, 6 years for the Senate,
uh-huh.
4 years for the President.
Okay.
Vote them out. Term limits.
Term limits. The only ones that are like monarchs are the Supreme Court. Which I have
That's
no
right.
idea why.
Because they're supposed to be independent that way. But it doesn't work.
Yeah, well.
I mean, Antonin Scalia was anything but independent.
Listen, if you have enough Republican votes to put in another Antonin Scalia, then another Antonin Scalia becomes Supreme Court Justice. Or if you have, not progressive, though, what do you call it? If you have Blue Dog Democrats on one side, you know, moderate, whatever they want to call themselves, and then the rest of the Republican. And then you have a moderate, compromising, bipartisan type of Supreme Court justice, which sucks. They'll become in for life.
Yeah.
You know, so it's like...
But the problem is, they keep voting the same ones back in. They do not honor term limits.
Oh, you mean like the Congress and the Senate?
That's correct.
That's because you got a bunch of... you got a bunch of stupid, imbecilic, brain cell deficient people living in all those southern and western states that are hoodwinked and hypnotized by their evangelical cult and believe all the lies.
Yes, they do.
Like the one that doesn't want to go to a hospital when he's really sick because he doesn't want to accept something called charity care. He wants to put the whole hospital, the whole doctor, the doctor bill and hospital stay on his tab because he's too proud to accept charity care.
Well, but if he can afford to put it on his tab, maybe he can afford to pay for it.
And no, he can't afford to
pay
for it.
Then why? Then he's talking nonsense.
He's talking like a redneck teabagger that votes Republican. That lives in a fucking shack. Well, like the ones in Kentucky.
He's talking nonsense
that,
then.
That keep on re-electing the same Republicans. Yes. He's talking nonsense. Exactly.
We need to lower taxes for everyone. And also defeat this lie that Hillary Clinton and the left keep saying that Republicans only want tax cuts for the wealthy.
Listen, Hillary, do not put Hillary Clinton in with the left wing, please.
Yeah, they continue to do that, don't they?
Left wing. Ha ha ha, left wing.
Also, Trump proposed cutting down on regulations, which I think is a great idea, seeing as how the complexity and vast amount of federal regulations are a cost burden on businesses of all sizes and consumers.
MSNBC keeps on calling the DNC and the Hillary campaign and Wasserman Schultz progressive. Yeah. They keep on saying, using the word progressive. That's a lie.
We should take the government's boot off the neck of prosperity. Let the American people keep... invest
prosperity
and save more of their money.
Oh yeah, like and owning your own home in the United States is part of the dream. It's your home. You're a homeowner. Yeah. My ass, you're a homeowner. You're my ass. You can't even collect rainwater. If the government wants your house, they could take it. You're not a homeowner.
Anytime.
They could search your house without a warrant. You're not a homeowner.
It's time that the progressives stop micromanaging our economy so we can have more freedom and more prosperity.
I wish the progressives really were in some form of managerial capacity in charge. There are none. There are no real progressives in charge.
That is correct.
In as far as I know, in any state.
That is correct.
And in Washington.
The closest you got to a progressive right now is Moonbeam over in California.
Oh,
That's about it.
The one that allowed Peter Brabeck of Nestle's to bottle up all that water during a drought.
There you go.
The one who didn't stand up against the frackers.
There you go.
Yeah, he's real progressive. Yeah. The one that does not yet have legalized medical and recreational marijuana.
Marijuana.
Meanwhile, Oregon and Washington have legal both recreational and medical marijuana. Oh, but the feds could come. You just can't smoke it in front of the feds. Because the federal government Again, I heard on 1010 Winds Radio, the
you
federal...
You give us 22 minutes and we'll give you the world.
Yeah, tick, 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 tick. You know, they got like a 60-minute show, you know, noise. Beep, 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 beep. Anyway, the FDA says there is no evidence that marijuana does anything medically for you. That is one of the biggest flat-out lies that were ever spoken.
Well, look what they say about cancer and the alternative methods. They say the same damn thing.
Marijuana is...
Quack, quack, quack!
It's the tip of the iceberg. It is like aloe vera. It is so immensely versatile in terms of medical applications. It is extremely positively medicinal and miraculous. You know, it is very versatile, and not just medically. The fabric superior to cotton, hemp. You know, it could be made into much better plastics.
Mm-hmm.
It's probably the number one cash crop in the history of mankind. All around. Versatility. So, perhaps the government wants to keep it illegal so they can get all that free labor in those privatized prisons. Boss hog.
That's what's happening. House Speaker Paul Ryan.
Skooma.
Has defeated a long shot Republican primary challenger who had been praised by Donald Trump.
See what you said before? They keep on reelecting.
Yes.
The same scum.
Yes.
Over and over and over and over. And I hear Wasserman Schultz is way ahead in her polls.
Yes.
In Florida. Florida.
Yes.
The state of Florida. What idiots! What idiots are the American people? You truly are, in the words of my friend, personal trainer to the stars, Mario Petras, the creator Mario Petras, you really are a waste of sperm. You know, you Americans today.
Ryan beat businessman Paul Nehlen in Tuesday's Wisconsin primary.
Not Kevin Nealon of the Saturday Night Live crew. This is Paul Nehlen.
Nehlen had been courting Trump supporters and won praise from the Republican presidential nominee last week. But Trump endorsed Ryan days later. Another forced activity from the GOP.
Oh, that ring always manages to wiggle its way in the old schnozola of all these tough independent personalities that we have here in the United States, talking tough, just like the guys I know that talk real macho and tough privately with me, but they never dare voice their opinion publicly.
Ryan had largely ignored Nehlen in what had been a sleepy primary before Trump thanked Nehlen on Twitter for his comments defending Trump. Nehlen won the backing of some prominent conservative figures, including former Alaska Governor Sarah Palin.
Nehlen Palin and her slut little piggy daughter Bristol.
But it was not enough to overcome Ryan's popularity in his southeastern Wisconsin district.
Boy, this has been a very Trumpy show. We've had a lot of Trump readings.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to have to see if there's a new caricature of Donald Trump.
Maybe there'll be
the front cover of the show.
I think we're going to have a couple more.
Oh,
Trump
definitely.
Trump is around. He's in the papers, baby.
He's in the papers. Yeah, let me do a little Trump for you.
Right. I don't remember what I said!
Seven bells for old orange hair. Radioactive head of Donald Trump. Go ahead.
When are the Record, that's our local newspaper, editorials going to be just a little accurate with the facts?
Depends on whether the facts are real facts.
Your editorial on Donald Trump's financial policy states all the stats about how good it's been under President Obama.
It hasn't been good.
Millions of new jobs, but only if you don't mind part-time work or low-wage jobs. There's low unemployment, but the lowest ever work participant rate.
You know, when Bill Clinton was president, a lot of those jobs that he was bragging about, there were hamburger flipping jobs.
22 million. Yeah, but that's all's left. What do you expect when you only got 9% manufacturing in this country anymore?
9%, right?
9%. It's like Saudi Arabia. You sir heard what the guy said. We don't make nothing.
We don't make anything anymore.
Well, if you don't make anything, how are you going to sell anything?
They don't make anything because they don't have to. These are oil-rich countries, the United Arab Emirates.
Yeah, they were blessed.
The average person is very, very comfortable.
They were blessed with that black gold.
Texas tea.
Texas tea.
Oh, the first thing you know, old Jed's a millionaire. Oh. Kin folks said, Jed, move away from there. All right, go ahead.
Low inflation. Yes, that's because no one has money to spend.
See, that's what would... Remember that banner about... It is not communism that will kill capitalism. It is consumers that won't have any money to buy anything.
The high stock market benefits the rich, and there are low interest rates, but that means that the retired middle class is not seeing interest being earned on their investments. Last but not least, there are low gas prices. But Obama and the Democrats have done everything in their power to block fracking and put holds on most fossil fuels. The low prices are because of free enterprise, not because of the Democrats.
Are you done with that? Because I have a question for you.
Go ahead.
I don't mean to digress.
But you will.
But I will. Late at night, keep on seeing this commercial lately where Henry Winkler, the Fonz, is talking about the
reverse mortgage.
Reverse mortgage for seniors.
Guess who else is doing it?
Who?
Tom Selleck.
Tom Selleck?
Mustache and all.
Is this concept of a reverse mortgage a trick to sucker retired seniors? I mean, it sounds like it's free money. I mean, how could it be?
No, it's not free money. It's money that is your equity in your home. Suppose you got a $400,000 mortgage.
But then if you...
And you've paid off $370,000. You've got $30,000 to play with. They'll give you the $30,000. Reverse mortgage.
But...
You still own the house.
How could you still own the
house? You still own the house. But...
But if you sell it, you won't get your money. You won't get the money you...
Yeah. You won't, but probably the guy that if you die and he gets the house, he will. There's some problem with it. I'm not up, you know, on it all, but there is some sort of problem. But it is your money, the equity in your house. So, the company who's giving you that obviously has some sort of stipulations in there that they're going to take this house from you if you don't pay it back.
That's why it's
okay.
That's why the word it kind of bothered me when he kept on saying reverse mortgage. I mean, people are happy when they pay off their homes.
Exactly.
And they burn the mortgage and they have a party.
If you pay off your home, for Christ's sake, then you got the $400,000 equity, I guess.
It's based on the current appraisal of your home, the current net.
How much you still have left?
How much you have left?
I mean, how much you have paid off?
Oh, okay, okay.
The what you have left is your reverse mortgage. It's some sort of borrowing, okay? It's got to be.
Yeah.
And there lies the problem, because somebody has a lien on that.
There you go.
Okay.
I think the most embarrassing celebrity commercial was Viagra or Cialis. I don't see it anymore. Some older celebrity is advertising it, saying, "I take it. I'm not ashamed." Nah, you don't tell the world you take it. It's nobody's business. But anyway, I guess they paid him enough.
Speaking of Donald Trump, he spoke about the economy on Monday.
Oh, boy.
And Hillary Clinton spoke about it on Thursday.
Yeah, it's in the crapper. It's the shits.
There's a lot of talk about bringing back jobs that have been outsourced. But there's no talk of the jobs at home that have disappeared forever.
Oh, yeah.
Here are a few examples of extinct jobs.
Oh.
New Jersey and Oregon are the only two states in which gas station attendants pump gas.
Is that so? Everything else is self-service? But you know what's funny? Anytime I was in a state where they had self-serve gas stations, the price of the... You would think, because there's no
people... Yeah, it should go down.
You would think the price of the gas would be down. Hell no, the price of the gas was higher than it was in New Jersey that had employees working there.
See?
Higher. How is it higher? It's bullshit.
Anywhere else, the driver usually does it. Airlines have cut back counter help significantly. Passengers must now weigh their own bags. And even put the airline's luggage tag on the suitcase while they get their own boarding pass.
You know what else those stingy motherfuckers don't do? I don't think they give you the little snacks that they used to give you.
No.
You miserable bastards. This is your capitalism. That major airlines don't bring you the... I remember when they used to bring you the bag of this, a peanuts, or this and that, anything you wanted.
I was reading something the other day. Some guy was telling a story about a person who was on who was going on a cruise on a ship.
Right.
And he took along crackers and cheese.
Yeah.
Because he didn't want to eat on board the ship because he didn't want to pay.
Oh, it wasn't an all-inclusive cruise then.
You're getting ahead of me.
Okay. Tiny bubbles.
So after 3 days of eating crackers and cheese, he's a little, verklempt. He don't want any more. So he happens to be talking to this guy, and he mentions the problem. This guy tells him, but the food is included in your passage.
Stupid bastard, motherfucking idiot. He didn't know this from the itinerary?
Well,
didn't he get a brochure?
I don't know what the hell he got.
The fucking moron. He didn't know that all-inclusive would have meant. He didn't know that.
I guess so.
And he's the one. This is the one of our American voters that we have here in this country. You stupid ass.
Many stores are happy to provide customers with self-checkout cash registers. It saves them money. Also, just try to find a salesperson on the floor at some department store.
Good luck. Good luck trying to find a needle in a haystack.
They are a thing of the past.
Nah, you don't
What about that greeter at Walmart?
No more.
With the green jacket.
No more.
Wow.
And there's no more person checking your receipt when you leave. You know, the security person? They're not there either. No greeter. No security person. You go into a department. You look for an associate. Most departments really don't have any. They just, they have people that just put out the merchandise overnight. And that's it. I mean, there's a few departments that have employees, but most of them, no. And then if you flag somebody down, they don't understand what you're saying. They don't know. They don't have the answer.
Well, like our local shop right here, they don't stock the damn shelves. Restock once they run out. You know what I mean?
Well, it's usually...
not even overnight.
It's usually a good management practice to not to wait until you're totally depleted of a popular item. You wait. You always keep your inventory, your stock room full of when it's a popular item that sells well. You don't wait until you have nothing.
I'm dealing with a vitamin company right now where my particular vitamin is out of stock.
Out of stock.
And it's been out of stock for almost a week. How do you do that?
It's only common sense that, you know, that you don't allow yourself to get out of stock if you know something sells.
Exactly.
You don't allow yourself to do that. You know, it's common sense. It's not. You don't need an MBA.
They don't want to carry inventory. You know what I mean?
But if you don't have the product, you don't make the sale.
Exactly.
If the customer wants something.
Bingo.
And you don't have it.
And especially today, because he's going elsewhere.
The customer. I heard a guy pronounce the word customer one time. He was yelling at the cashier, I am the customer. I am the customer. So, I'm just making a joke. But the customer will go somewhere else if they need it. If it's not frivolous, if it's something they need and want, they'll go somewhere else. Somebody else will make the sale.
Right.
It's gotta be there in order to sell. It's not gonna sell in the back room. It's not gonna sell if it isn't in the warehouse.
Yeah.
You know? And that's that. Now, as far as Walmart goes, I have a trick. I don't get myself aggravated anymore. I go on the Walmart website and I find what I need there, then I have it sent to my local Walmart, free shipping. They don't charge you for that. I go in, I go all the way in the back of the store. There's a department where you pick up online orders. Give them your name. Oh, show a little ID. Oh, here's your item. It's already paid for because you paid online. It's sitting there waiting for it, but at least you're getting it. And they tell you by email when it arrives.
There you go.
They tell you that when it's there. Because retail is really, as far as the retail stores go, they're really cutting back on employees. It's almost like so many people are shopping online that it's almost like they're trying to phase out the retail stores.
Well, here this is just an example of what you're just talking about, and it is impossible to account for the number of jobs that online stores have eliminated.
There you go.
What happens over time becomes part of the culture.
Well, retail stores.
Right after I retired from teaching in a local high school, one person was hired to be the head of the English social studies and language departments. A high school is not the check-in counter at an airport and can't be treated that way. The above jobs are gone for good. A presidential candidate can boast about bringing them back, but they can't.
In other words, the damage has already been done.
We're bleeding.
To our economy.
We're bleeding.
You know, Donald Trump brags about how he's going to restore everything, make America great again, bring the jobs back, and all that stuff. I don't believe anything anymore. Ever since Bernie Sanders decided not to take up the Green Party on their offer, and you know, I'm confused. I mean, did he officially publicly resign from the campaign, Bernie Sanders?
No.
He has not. He endorsed Hillary Clinton.
That's correct.
He did not resign. Now, and of course, he hasn't given the Green Party an answer in 5 years that they've been pursuing him. The Green Party, the Jill Stein people said to me that they've been doing it for the last 5 years, and the last 5 years he's been blowing them off. I don't know what problem he has with the Green Party. It was good enough for the great Ralph Nader. Maybe it's a little too far. Maybe they're a little too progressive for Bernie Sanders. You know what I mean? You know, it sounded like he was very progressive when he campaigned, but I don't know. I don't know what problem he has. Did he ever have an affair with Jill Stein?
No, come on.
And he's embarrassed? So it has nothing. See, I try to make logic sense out of a lot of things, and I can't. I just can't, you know? It's like.
He wanted to go with the bigger boys and girls.
But the bigger boys and girls.
There's more votes there.
But the bigger boys and girls are the establishment he trashed
right.
throughout his entire campaign.
Right, but that's where the votes are.
So the votes are that you go with the same old, business as usual, bipartisanship, blah, 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 capitalism.
Well, he put up a good front.
Fucking
but, you know,
wins
they
again.
They didn't buy it. They bought the status quo with Hillary.
So health care continues to be privatized.
That's
no universal health care. Students have to pay off their student loans. And the same old crap continues. Meanwhile, Northern Europe lives happily ever after. And we don't.
Okay. At all levels of government, we've seen to have the wrong representatives.
And it's going to continue.
These are people furthering their own careers and doing what is best for the few who support them. We have a billionaire and a very wealthy professional politician vying for the top spot of what seems to be an entertainment circus.
An insane asylum, too.
Even on a local level, we have elected officials more interested in money than in the betterment of their communities as a whole. Sorry, but the time has come to give a piece of the blame to the media for not looking out for the people of this mighty nation.
Could you imagine if just the media alone remained unbiased and just gave everybody both sides of the real truth, then the American people would have options and they would know what everyone has done by the fruits of their labor and what they say, their behavior, what they're for, what they're against. Then they would know everything.
Well, we used to have basically a fair use type of situation where if a Republican said something, then the Democrats
rebuttal. Editorial.
But Mr. Reagan had that change.
I used to see that on when I was in high school. I used to see that locally. A New York station, I think it was, it might have been WPIX Channel 11 or WOR Channel 9, but there was the the rebuttal, you know, there was the two sides of every issue, and you heard the editorial rebuttal to the original person speaking, and you know, like a debate, like a fair debate, you know, and then if it was unbiased, people would know about Jill Stein,
or at least presenting both issues, both sides of the coin. That's all. You
right,
know.
And then they can make an intelligent decision because they would know the options. But you know, if the system only wants to have a Republican and a Democrat at a debate, televised debate, and they don't want you to know about independents or any other third parties, you know, I don't know.
It's time for democracy to spread its wings.
Yeah, sure.
We need a more direct, a democratic nation where people decide their own fates and the nation.
Don't hold your breath.
Our best and brightest have turned against the people.
There is...
And it is time to hold them accountable.
Good luck. Torches and pitchforks. That's the only thing we need that we don't have. You know, it's like, it's almost like we might as well just do real accurate Bible study interpretation, because, you know, doing all this politics, it's just that nothing changes because the people themselves don't change. We the people have not changed, and we don't want change. So if we the people are not willing to get tough,
we keep yapping about it, though, don't we?
Everybody yaps and complains. See, this is what kills me about this is what aggravates me about, let's say, online social media. Nah. Everybody's is a brilliant know-it-all guru. Everybody gives their rebuttal and their take on every subject, day and night. You know, they post, they give their comments, some of them very long-winded comments. But, okay, let's say they're full of shit and they don't vote at all, then they're total assholes, dickheads. Let's say they do vote. Okay. I bet 9 times out of 10, or even greater odds, even 99.9% of the time, I bet they vote for either a Democrat or a Republican. If their comments are progressive, I bet 99.9% they vote for a Democrat. You're still voting for the establishment. You got to get out of the establishment. You got to vote. You got to go for the third party. You got to go for the independent. You know what I mean? If you keep on voting within the two-party system, nothing will change. So you could be as brilliant as you want, you know? And believe me, they use big words. They try to be like amateur political analysts, you know, even more, much fancier than that Steve Audubon Society. What's his name? Audubato?
Steve Audubato.
Steve Audubato here in New Jersey. He's everywhere. He's even on the, he was on the local New Jersey news channel 12 when we had Optimum. Now I have Verizon Files, which is Channel 1, is the their New Jersey station. He's there too. He's like the go-to guy for politics in New Jersey. But these people online are even more fancier than him, much more. But if you're still just like Steve Audubato, just like all the political analysts on the media, they only talk in terms of Republican or Democrat. They never go outside that box.
Never. Little change of pace here.
Tomato paste.
About a decade ago, there was not a single specimen of a particular Asian beetle on the loose in New Jersey.
Oh. I haven't seen them, by the way. You mean the Japanese beetle?
Now, there are hundreds of thousands of them, perhaps even millions. But this isn't another invasion by a non-native pest. These tiny weevils were released into New Jersey on purpose.
I wonder if those are the black weevils. They are weevils. I've seen them. They got in the house, you know. They move slow. They're kind of cute in their own way.
And they've become the state's most potent weapon against a mile a minute, an invasive vine that has overrun natural areas. I just bit my cheek. Killing native trees and shrubs.
Wait a minute. there's a pestilence that are destroying native trees and shrubs. This weevil was introduced to
it says an invasive vine.
Oh, the vine.
They must eat the vine.
You know, there's a problem with introducing an invasive species for good reasons. Sometimes it bites you on the ass and it creates a new problem. But
you mean like Jurassic Park?
No, like the cane toad in Australia. Uh-huh. They introduced the cane toad from South America for the farmers to get rid of the vermin, and now they're up to their earlobes in cane toads.
There you go.
And there's no natural enemy for the toad, because the toad protects itself with toxin squirted out of its warts. That's why toads and salamanders or newts, they have warts. It's toxic. It squirts right in the mouth of a predator.
The State Department of Agriculture began raising the weevils in 2004 at its beneficial insect rearing laboratory in West Trenton. After years of research by federal government to ensure there would be no negative effects on the environment from releasing the weevils.
Yeah, to be sure there's no negative effects.
It's a complicated process for federal approval, said Mark Mayer, supervising entomologist with the lab.
Yeah, but these weevils must be a predator that will eat them.
Huh?
And the problem with, if they're in the beetle family, is that many beetles give off a chemical in it as part of their defense system.
You have to do the science first. Do the homework. Make sure there's not going to be a problem by releasing them. Other than ripping up the vine seedlings, each spring, over thousands of affected acres, there's no better tool than the weevils to keep a mile a minute in check. Because that's what these weevils love to eat.
Is that the nickname of this vine, the Mile a Minute?
Mile a Minute vine, yeah.
And where the Mile a Minute vine is not from this country.
It's in America. Where do you think it's from?
No, but I mean it's a native vegetation.
But it's out of.
It's out of control.
Out of control. Out of control.
Well, they better bring back the that mosquito larva eating fish.
Uh-huh.
Because, you know, now the mosquito, not only can have West Nile virus, but the Zika, right?
Yeah.
Zika.
You know, I never heard of Zika until like 2-3 months ago.
Yeah. Well, you know what I mean? We got time for one more, right?
Oh, yeah. My husband and I have a close friend who started dating a woman he met online.
It's very common nowadays. People really don't hang out in bars per se anymore.
He seemed starry-eyed.
Unless you're young.
Then, out of the blue, she texted me from his phone to say she wouldn't tolerate him hanging out with me. Unless we were with other people.
Oh, she don't trust him with having a female friend. But he knew her before dating her, right?
Saying it was inappropriate for a man and a woman to spend time alone together. Unless they were a couple.
Alone? Well, you know, she does have a point. A man who's seriously involved being alone with a female friend, it can lead to trouble. I agree.
She insinuated that we were sleeping together.
Hey, if there's no witnesses, anything can happen.
Our friend told us that she had broken into his phone while he slept.
Oh, to snoop. Oh, she could be a control freak there. Huh? That's not good. She's snooping.
She read our extremely platonic texts and flew into a jealous rage, waking him up by screaming at him.
Listen, I've seen girlfriends that felt they had the authorization to go through a man's wallet, dresser, drawer, closet. If you're in the shower, I'm telling you, make sure you choose a password. Make sure you don't choose your birth date as your password for your email. You know what I mean?
In the next few weeks, it proved to be just part of a larger pattern of cruel and irrational behavior. So far, she has accused him of cheating on her, of being gay, and not really loving her.
Pay attention to me, worship me. She's very insecure.
She implies that she'll sleep with other men to punish him.
It's like Raymond's wife, you know, he can't even play golf on Sunday. Gotta pay 24/7. She's gotta be the focus. She, the mother of his children.
She flips out over things beyond his control, like his work schedule. Meanwhile, he's paid off her substantial credit card debt racked up before they met.
Oh my God, this guy's a real pussy whipped ass kisser.
She finally pushed in far enough that he broke up with her.
What an idiot, paying off her credit card debt.
He came to my husband and me repeatedly for support.
No, screw you. You paid off her credit card debt, and they're not even married when he did it, right?
We tried to be kind but honest.
Idiot.
Pointing out the obvious red flags.
What an idiot.
Later, he crumpled to her combination of pleading and guilt trips. And to our horror, got back together with her. They're in couples therapy. And he now says that they both made mistakes and swears that everything is now wonderful.
Yeah, right.
And they're talking about marriage.
Yeah, just like...
She's aware that we were fully in support of their breakup. She doesn't want him around us. He wants us to apologize to her and give her a chance. I feel like our choices are apologize to this toxic woman and pretend she doesn't repulse us, or lose our friend, perhaps permanently. Do you see a third option, Amy?
No, just tell like it is. If you take the loss, you take the loss.
Amy says, before caving to the two options this raging bully has offered you, you should at least ask her to refine the parameters of her demand. Based on what you report, it sounds as if she is asking you and your husband to apologize for being loyal friends with the person she is now claiming exclusive dibs on.
Yeah, exclusive dips. Yeah, control freak.
The four of you should meet in an effort to clear the air. If she demands an apology because you were not supportive of their relationship during their breakup, you should tell her quite honestly that your loyalty and support is toward her friend, your friend, and given her behavior toward you personally. Surely, she couldn't expect anything else.
Yeah, she's the outsider, not him.
You can offer, so yeah, no. We won't be apologizing to you today, but we would be very happy to give you a chance to behave differently toward us. You should also tell him, we want you to be happy. We want you to get what you want. If this relationship is what you want, then we only wish you well. We want you to know that we will always be here for you. You don't need to declare her off limits. She will likely make this choice for all of you.
I'm telling you, nowadays it's very difficult to meet somebody that's normal and not dysfunctional, and somebody who's mentally stable. You know, it is. And of course, people change as soon as you decide to move in together and cohabitate with each other.
Then you
find out
person comes out.
The real person comes out. But you know, I used to work back in the day. I used to work with the general public, and I have learned that I'm not too crazy about people. I only like certain ones. But like I said, it's difficult to find somebody who is not dysfunctional. You know, you don't need a brilliant person.
Excuse me.
As your significant other, they don't have to be very smart, but they can at least be unselfish and have some common sense.
Hey.
Yeah, decency. You know, but unselfish is the key. This woman obviously is very selfish.
Mm-hmm.
You know, she needs to control him, and she's very insecure. So anyway, I don't know if it's based on past issues in her life, but that should not be their problem or his problem.
Mm-hmm.
But anyway, thank you for joining us. We'll see you next time on Progressive Discussions, and I don't know what to say politically. I know I'm not going to vote for anybody in the Republican or Democratic Party ever again. Let's see what happens. You know, let's see what happens with Jill Stein. Let's see if the Bernie-crats, go over to her in legions. Let's see if Bernie comes out of hibernation and says anything. I really don't know what to tell you. But getting back to, Gentleman Jack, shame on you. That hospital, to go from $40 in a couple years to over $100 for his medical records, updating his medical records, it's definitely dishonest. All right, we'll see
you. You know, some hospitals, they don't have your records after like 20 years. Some after 10.
Yeah. Well, supposedly, he had to go to this, like, third party, this office that wasn't part of the hospital,
mm-hmm.
that was holding the records.
But depending on how old they are, they're not on site anymore. Yeah.
Yeah, well, they're only going to be there. Well, if somebody requests updated records.
Yeah.
I think in this case it was for Social Security, but
right.
if you're dealing with the government, they're gonna find any reason they can, nitpicky reason to deny you.
Yeah.
You know, even if they will deny you by default at the beginning, but if you're one of their very wealthy bed buddies and you want something, you'll get it in a flash. You'll get it in a flash, no questions asked. If you're a little schmuck that wants a little something, a handful of crumbs, good luck. Alright.
Yeah, ask Hansel and Gretel for the crumbs.
Yeah, Hansel and Gretel. Was there a witch that wanted to cook them and eat them?
That's correct, in the oven.
Because they were young and tender?
That's correct.
Oh, was the oven?
In the oven.
She said, get close to the oven?
I don't know what you said, but that's what you wanted to do with
her. Uh-huh.
She was a cannibal.
She was a cannibal.
Yeah.
She wanted to, she was German. She wanted to make sauerbraten out of them.
This has been a Megalife 21 production.